Simpson. This is Roberts to Stroud. Turns on Hines, cut off. Up top, Singh, seven on the shot clock. Drives, Mitrovic goes up, got it!
Mitrovic with the turnaround!
Great quick relief by Mitrovic, just taking his chance while he can to get that shot off.
The shot clock had almost expired. Churchill, Hines, and now Stroud's got a foul.
Gaels foul.
And if the Gaels aren't going to be able to be physical with Hines, it's going to be a long night.
As his first foul of the evening. Substitution for the Ravens into the game, number 3, Gavin Rich.
Hines. Hands off to Thomas Scrub. Hines. 5 on the shot clock. Hines turns. Layup.
Hines.
Rice, the best player in the country. Pretty calm, taking it down low there. Ten on the shot clock as we hit midway in this first quarter. All Ravens, 5 on the shot clock. Singh, somebody needs to shoot. Singh will, and he banked it in. You gotta call it last,
Singh
there, freak.
Uses the bank.
He'll take it though, he'll take it.
Good catch there by Resch. Hines. Foul away from the ball, and this is on Singh. That'll be the Gaels' 4th team foul.
Gaels foul of charge number 7, Supreme Singh. That's his first of the evening.
Patrick Street checks in the game
for the Gaels. Number 11, Patrick Street.
Queen. I'm one of those few players that you're going to see dribbling probably a lot more than some of the guards.
Queen's band trying to get the noise level going here in the arc. 12-6, Carleton leading early. First quarter. Stroud. And Churchill picks up the foul.
Ravens foul, charge number 41.
Dave Smart fires with Philip Scrub, in fact, the inbounder. Because of putting Churchill in a bad spot. Roberts, Stroud, hand off to Singh with 8 on the shot clock. Tried to get it into Stroud, Hines anticipated, makes a steal. Hines, Phillips Scrub, up top to Churchill. Scrub drives baseline, gets it to brother Thomas. Inside, Churchill gets 2 Gaels in the air, lays
Churchill.
It in.
The patience on the offensive end by the Carleton Ravens is something to really notice. They all distribute impeccably.
Roberts. Singh, and again, 10 on the shot clock for the Gaels. I think this is what the Gaels want to do. They want to take their time, but they need to score. Mitrovic, somebody's got to shoot it. Street will. And didn't get rim. And the whistle late.
Substitution for the Gaels into the game, number 23, Mike Shoveler.
Ball, Paclabar and Shoveler check in for Stroud and Roberts.
Into the game
and in for Carleton.
Number 13.
And I'm with our PA announcer. We have no 13 on our roster, so we'll wait to find out who the mystery man is. This is where, as a play-by-play man, you hope he doesn't touch the ball. Have a quiet game, mystery man. And, of course, he's got it inside. Traveled, so no basket. I didn't see a travel there, but Gaels will take the call.
Traveling violation, charge for the Ravens.
Paclabar. Trapped. Just like that. You pick up your dribble in a corner and 5 seconds.
Ah, yes, the smothering comment you were saying. That might be a picture of
violation.
Ravens by 8. They beat the Gaels by 35 up at the Ravens Nest on January 24th. Phillip Scrub for 3. No. Long rebound kept alive by Hines. Phillip Scrub. Hines. Hines against Shubler. Rookie against fifth-year player. And Shubler holds his own. Ahead to Paklabar. Mitrovic. We're approaching 2 minutes left first quarter. Singh drives. Mitrovic for 3. Didn't get it off in time. Another 24-second shot clock violation for the Gaels.
Substitution for the Gaels in the game.
There definitely aren't the turnovers the Gaels want right now. Although they're not being converted into points at the other end, they are possessing the necessary because right now they're only trailing by a bit, but that could rack up pretty quick.
Resch. Thomas Scrub. Falling, gets it to Resch for 3. No, long rebound, back the bar. Simpson drives, hangs, draws a foul.
Simpson with the aggressive move to the hoop. He'll go to the line, shooting 2. Ravens foul, charge number 13, Sean Emmanuel, Pierre Charles.
So, number 43 in our roster is actually the mystery man number 13, Jean Emmanuel Pierre Charles. Simpson puts in both. Gaels within 6. Minute 40 left, opening quarter. Thomas Scrub. Scrub crossover. Short, rebound by Pierre Charles, foul on Street, I believe.
Gaels foul, charge number 11, Patrick Street. That's his first
game. If I see early fouls, I do like the Gaels, how the Gaels come out strong and not cowering away from the contact.
And the Gaels coaching staff has to be happier, Rachel, with the compete level than there was last night.
Yeah, definitely. Last night was a bit rough against Ottawa, but you know what? Both teams are great. Great shooting, great rebounding, so.
Very athletic.
Yep, another chance to compete right now.
Hines comes out, Churchill comes in.
For the Ravens, into the game number 41, Kevin Churchill.
Paklabar. Ball back. Driving Singh. Circus shot misses. Pierre Charles with the rebound. Outlet to Phillip Scrub with a minute left in the quarter. Scrub drives out of control. And Singh's going to get called for the reach before the charge. And it's going to send Scrub to the line for 2.
It'll be Singh's
second
7,
personal, and Roberts will return for Sukhpreet.
That's his second of the evening. Substitution for the Gaels into the game number 4, Horshane Roberts.
Phillip Scrub is one of those players that no one in CIS can guard one-on-one. He is the only player in the country who plays here for university who was invited to the national team tryout, so he is a player, to say the least.
Scrub hits both. He's got 5 in the game. Ravens up by 9, their biggest lead of the first quarter. 50 seconds left in this opening quarter. Simpson, lane opens, drives into Pierre Charles and draws the foul. That's 2 quick ones on number 13. So it took us longer to figure out his name than it did for him to stay on the floor.
Simpson finds himself back at the line, 3rd time in the first quarter. It's great that he's initiating himself, getting aggressive into the hoop.
Simpson hits the first. McKenzie matches his number on his uniform as he's got 6 points. Gaels to within seven. Philip Scrub just got it over the timeline, feeds Thomas. Stop by Philip Scrub is short, but Thomas gets the rebound and he travels.
You can't do that, that's a traveling violation in charge of the Ravens.
Roberts. 7 second difference between shot and game clock. Street for three. Short. Rebound Churchill. Shot clock off. Philip Scrub. Rasso. Churchill. 2 seconds left. Goes. Misses the layup. Dave Smart, irate at his team offensively.
Ravens will take
yet they're still up seven as we end the first quarter. And Rachel,
how can you please make some noise for the Queens Juniors?
Dave Smart not pleased with the offense, but sure looks effective from here.
And you know what? Best case scenario right now for the Gaels, because Carleton has missed a lot of bunnies inside. And you can even look on the players' faces. They're upset with themselves and they make silly turnovers like that last travel call or the miss inside by Churchill. Right now, we see Patrick Street. He was the leading scorer for the Gaels when they played at the Ravens Nest a few weeks ago.
Right,
Thomas Scrub is glued to him. He's not giving him an inch. That's why that last three was so contested.
I'm here with Nick and Sean, who are best friends.
Gaels will finish up their season at Toronto, at Ryerson. They're not locked into the sixth spot yet. They're still only 2 points back of fifth place York, 4 points back of fourth place Laurentian. And Laurentian will finish next weekend with Carleton in Ottawa. But York will also get Toronto and Ryerson next week. So the Gaels, you would think, need to get two wins out of these last three games at least to entertain any chance of getting a home playoff game in the quarterfinals. And if not, they're going back to Ryerson on the 19th for a quarterfinal game.
Which no one wants because Ryerson at home is another tough team to beat. But you know, right now, wins are wins. They want to win every game. They're coming out of this game wanting to win. But in their last meeting, as we were talking about, the second quarter was probably the worst for the Gaels, so they're going to try to not repeat what happened, where they were outscored 20-12. Because Carlton's going to come out with vengeance right now, because Smart is letting his team know what they need to do on offense. Pretty much put the basket.
Sean said red.
There wasn't a lot of drawing on the chalkboard there. There was a lot of yelling at Philip Scrub, especially number 23. Wanting to see him need a little bit more ball movement.
He didn't need the board, he was just painting pictures with
the board. Give him a round of applause for playing anyways. They tried, they'll go home with a great consolation prize and keep cheering on your
Gaels. So Philip Scrub, Clinton Springer Williams both with 5 points leading the Ravens. Mackenzie Simpson, 6 points, leads all scorers through a quarter, but it's the Ravens by seven as we start the second quarter.
And Simpson has the right idea, getting to the hoop, scoring with the clock stop. That's going to be key for the Gaels in this game.
Simpson, nice catch, Paklabar, nice feed to Street, who got hammered by Churchill. And Churchill's coming off.
Street gets hit on the back cut. He'll go to the line shooting.
Excellent pass by Paklabar, set up that play, and the pump fake inside by Street.
Number 41.
He knew Churchill was going to go for it.
That's his second of the evening.
Connor Wood comes out, as does Churchill. Thomas Scrub comes in with Clinton Springer Williams. Street hits the first. One of two. Scrub beats Hines. Springer Williams, floater, no, rebound Street. Ahead to Simpson. Simpson cut off, tries to go up, misses, loose ball. Hines can't find it. Now he gets it to Philip Scrub. Rasso open at the 3-point line, but Scrub doesn't get it to him. He gets it to Springer Williams. behind. Misses the easy bunny. Dave Smart is about to lose his mind with his team right now. He's holding his forehead. If you just were watching your first OUAA game, you would think the 19-0 team wore gold. The best team in the country is in white, and their head coach is exasperated with how his team's playing right now. Scrub, one-hander, got it.
Scrub, the best player on Carleton right now, is just going to probably take it into his own hands. He puts the points on the board for his team.
Some full-court pressure now by the Ravens. Paklabar gets it over the timeline. Paklabar for three. Short. Scrub comes away. Brother Thomas was open deep. Now he'll get the ball. Shoveler gets the foul.
Gaels foul, charge to number 23.
I know Dave quite well. I had a chat with him at halftime of the women's game. He's so competitive, such a great coach, that even though his team is 19-0, he's disgusted right now at a lack of execution. Because for him, perfection's what he's going for.
You know, and that's how you win championships. And he makes his players accountable, and they're okay with that. They want to be accountable because that's how you become the best.
Paklabar needs to get it over the timeline. It does. 20-11, Carleton leading. They've led from the opening tip. Early second quarter, Bill Miklas, along with Rachel Orosovic. Roberts drives. Simpson. Mislencevic fires up the two. Didn't get rim. Third shot clock violation against the Gaels this half.
Another shot clock violation in charge of the Gaels.
Yeah, fadeaway three with 1 second left with Thomas Scrub challenging it isn't the easiest shot to make.
Thomas Scrub against Shoveler. Can't hit, but then got the tip.
Scrub for two.
It's offensive rebound.
Roberts. Drives. Left hand layup misses. A lot of empty trips right now for the Gaels. Thomas Scrub lays it in.
Scrub for two.
Roberts still with no points on the board. Leading scorer last night was 16 against Ottawa.
Lead has been extended to 13. Slencevich. Nice step through. Feeds Shoveler for two.
Shoveler off the nice feed from Slencevich.
Rasso. Gaels' first field goal there by Shoveler of the second quarter. It took almost 3 minutes. Philip Scrub, pull up from the elbow, got it. Timeout, Gaels. And now it's Stephen Barry's turn to be upset with him.
And the Gaels will take a timeout.
Mike Shoveler.
Seems like every pull-up Philip Scrub takes is almost as though it's in practice. Same speed, same calmness. Everyone always comments on mouth guard being out of the mouth. Hey, whatever works.
You look at the two huddles. If you look at the Queens huddle and then you look over at the Carleton huddle, again, if you're just joining us, you would think Carleton was not playing very well, at least to their head coach, Dave Smart. They're not, yet they're still up 13.
He looks genuinely distraught. But you know what? He's going to fix it because he has everyone else on the bench who can file in and fit in and hit shots as well.
Let's make some noise.
Their entire bench is efficient. That's the problem with playing Carleton. They can always sub somebody else in.
Well, and knowing Dave Smart like I do, he looks big picture. So when he's watching a game and the offense is struggling and not playing well, he knows this is the way to play if you want to win the national championship. And that's how Carleton gauges their seasons off those men. Now, an interesting note, Rachel, is for the men, their final four is at a predetermined site, and it will be hosted by Ryerson this year. Ryerson might not even be playing if they don't get bought win the East semifinal, but it means Carleton takes their undefeated record and doesn't get the luxury of the Ravens desk, because as we've both seen, that building is electric when they're playing at home.
That's so true. But this Ravens team knows how to win anywhere. And they will maybe show that tonight.
Miss Lencevich for three. No. And Scrub pulls it away. Ravens quickly into the front court. Philip Scrub crosses over. No look pass, knocked away by Street, but then knocked out of Stroud's hand. Roberts will bring it up the floor. Nope, single. Only a couple seconds to do it, and he just did. Got to Street, wanted to quick release it, but Rosso got there. Singh. Roberts over Scrub. Got it! You're going to beat the Ravens. You need to shoot well, but especially from behind the arc.
That was a great find by Singh over to Roberts. Quick release, count it for three.
First three-pointer made by the Gaels. In the half, they've taken eight of them. Singh with the steal off Thomas Scrub. Roberts. Street for three. No. Gaels need to make those. Get this crowd back in the game. Thomas Scrub almost turned it over. And Philip Scrub's going to draw the foul here on Patrick Street.
Street fighting hard to maintain position, not letting Scrub drive by him there. That was great defensive effort.
Connor Wood checks back in. Gaels
foul charge number 11, Patrick Street. That's his second of the evening.
Hines. Hand off to Philip Scrub. Gets stolen by Singh. Kicks it out. Street. Roberts. Long distance three. Got it! Got a roll from long distance. And the Gaels are within seven.
With another triple.
Roberts catching it right in rhythm. One of the best three-point shooters in the Gaels. He's now two for two.
His three with 1.4 seconds last Saturday night gave the Gaels a three-point win over Laurentian. Thomas Scrub, and he's fouled by Stroud. That'll be two on Ryle.
An unnecessary foul there by Ryle Stroud. But you know, the Gaels are coming out right now with defensive
Gaels
intensity.
Foul,
it's
14,
not letting
Ryle
Carleton
Stroud
get into any sort of groove.
That's
and Smart
meeting.
Is irate at the moment.
Substitution for the Gaels.
Well, knowing Dave like six. I do, he's not going to calm down until this one's over. The only man in the world that can win numerous national championships and never look happy. Philip Scrub off the inbound, misses the shot. Singh. Street. Walks into the three, misses it. Rebounds off Carleton and out of bounds.
Just seems like everything's either a second too late or a couple centimeters off for the Ravens right now.
Wow, and Patrick Street's game is those three-pointers. They need them. They're going to stay in the building with Carleton. Simpson will try a three. No, long rebound. Street keeps it alive. And then Connor Wood's going to get himself a seat back on the bench. Singh, plenty of time on the shot clock. Roberts was open. They didn't get it to him. Singh will pull up for two. No. Empty possessions for the Gaels.
They're getting some great looks on the offensive end.
Philip Scrub. Fade away. No. And Dave Smart saying, why do you need to fade away? Simpson drives, puts up the runner, and he gets the charge. Hines was waiting there.
Gaels offensive foul, charge number six, Mackenzie Simpson. That's his first foul of the evening. Substitution for the Ravens into the game number five, Springer Williams.
The opportunities are here for the Gaels right now, but they just can't seem to knock down a shot.
That's the problem. When Carleton's struggling like they are offensively, you got to take advantage.
Because these opportunities don't come very
often. No, I was going to say, they are going to heat up eventually. Hines, five on the shot clock. Turns, gets around Street and scores.
Sweet move by Hines down there. Little fake to the middle. Stayed with a strong hand and finished.
Singh, Simpson, Roberts. Roberts turns the corner, kicks it to Simpson. Nice pass.
Great find. Simpson coming back door. Down low.
That brings the score to within 7.
3.5 minutes left, first half. A very fast-moving first half. Hines for 3. That's unfair. 6'7", best Hines player in the country. And he can step out and hit a 3. Singh to Roberts. Roberts for 3. In and out. Rebound Springer Williams. Might have rolled his ankle. Philip Scrupp drives, fade away off 1 foot. And you can hear Dave Smart saying, what's with that shot? But in more colorful terms. And Thomas Scrupp picks up the foul.
I wish we could get a sound bite. I feel like that'd be really entertaining for all of the listeners back at home.
Dave would never let us like him on the floor, but it would be something to hear.
Into the game,
it's certainly something to see, and you don't know a lot of the time what he's saying. Mislencevic. Roberts on the curl. Misses badly on that one. Well, look at the shooting statistics for both teams at halftime, and I'm sure it'll say that the Gaels are not shooting well, to say the least. And you get too many we just mentioned it, you don't get many of these opportunities where Carleton is going dry on offense, and yet you're down 10.
Well, the problem with playing Carleton is that you're going to release quicker than you usually do. You're going to be moving a little faster than you usually do. So your rhythm isn't naturally at that pace and at that speed. So that might be why the Gaels are off a little bit right now. Hopefully they can get back and get into that momentum in the second.
Springer Williams hits the first. Carleton up 12, and certainly not playing that well by their standards. Mislencevic. Singh. But, for that matter, the Gaels aren't playing great either, and they're still in this one. Roberts pulls up for 2. That one won't fall. And after the 2 threes by Roberts, the Gaels have gone dry. 2 minutes left, first half. Hines, Philip Scrubb for 3. No, long rebound, Mislencevic got it. Ahead to Singh. Singh into the front court, pulls up. Scrubb got a piece of it, loose ball. And they're going to call Stroud on their foul? That'll be 3 on Ryle.
Gaels foul, charge number 14, Ryle Stroud. Substitution for the Gaels into the game, number 23, Mike Shublin.
The score right now is kind of baffling, 33-21 with under 2 minutes left here. The Ravens average 94 points a game, highest in the country. You know that they're struggling offensively.
Rasso hits the first free throw, and I'm sure that will also be shown in the halftime stats that they're not shooting well, they're turning the ball over. And if you could talk to both coaches at halftime, I'm sure they both say execution has been poor. Singh, under 2 minutes left, first half. Ravens have led from the start. It's been, Gaels have gotten to within 7 this quarter, but now they trail by 14. Roberts drives, scores, and the foul.
Roberts with the hoop in the heart.
Great finish against Springer Williams. 6'4". Roshane Roberts really felt his body in there, hung in the air, threw that foul. Now he has a chance to make a 3-point play.
Roberts will head to the line looking to finish off the old-fashioned 3-point play.
Rest checks back in for Carleton. Roberts, after hitting 2 threes, can't finish the old-fashioned 3, and now Resch is going to get called for over the back.
Seems like Mackenzie Simpson got swallowed there by some Ravens players.
Ravens foul charge number 42, Tyson Hines.
Now Dave Smart turns his ire on the officials. Lencevich. Nice fake handoff. Can't put in the layup. And Hines stepped out of bounds.
I feel like the dimensions of this court must be a little off. Or maybe it's just them right now. Unfortunate turnover for the Ravens.
Inbounds. Roberts and a moving pick on Shoveler.
The big men on the Gaels right now are just getting in foul trouble.
Number 23, Mike Shoveler.
He's got two. Ms. Lencevich has two. Singh has two. Stroud has three. But they're only down 12 to the best team in the country. Philip Scrub. Hines to Thomas Scrub. Misses the layup. Loose ball. Shoveler. Roberts. Singh almost bobbled it. Nice crossover. And he got pushed. No, he stepped out of bounds.
So this seems to be a half of turnovers and fouls.
It was 17-10 at the end of the first quarter. And it's an 18-13 second quarter in Carleton's favor. Under a minute left in the first half. Hines drives on Shoveler and it's just too strong. In a couple of years, Mike Shoveler will be able to guard Tyson Hines. Unfortunately, Tyson Hines has no more eligibility. And Dave Smart will want a timeout next stoppage. Roberts drives, hangs. It was blocked by Hines. He goes back up and draws the foul.
Roshane Roberts, his aggressiveness to the net and his persistence in getting the ball to the hoop is keeping his team in this game.
Ravens foul, Church number 42, Tyson Hines.
Hines, that's his second, so Churchill's going to come in for him.
Into the game for the Ravens, number 41, Kevin Churchill.
Roberts hits the first. He's got nine. Kenzie Simpson has eight. That's 17 of his team's 24. Roberts misses the second one. 4 second difference between shot and game clock. Ravens by 13. But I think a lot of people thought it was going to be a lot more, the deficit in favor of the best team in the country. Scrub drives. Nice feed to Churchill. He's cut off. Gets it out. Rasso, quick fire three. Won't fall. Churchill with the rebound. Goes up over Shoveler. Tipped in by Scrub. Right at the buzzer. So the Ravens go in up 15. But Dave Smart not happy. Rachel, you wonder if the Gaels could have really shot the lights out. They'd have a real shot at being ahead going into halftime. Instead, they're down 15.
This game would be so different if the Gaels were knocking down some shots, because Carleton, a team uncharacteristic of not hitting their shots, are struggling right now. And it's those offensive opportunities and those extra chances that are really keeping the Gaels trailing.
All right. Quickly, we're going to go down to the sideline for a quick interview with Queens head coach Stephen Barry.
We did some things well. We struggled on some other parts. We're going to have to rebound better in the second half for sure, but at least the effort was there to build on, and hopefully we can have a better second half.
Thank you very much, Coach.
All right, I'm back up here. 15-point Carleton lead at halftime. We're back with the second half after this. You're watching Gaels basketball, courtesy of Queens TV.
Between our ball boys, who have been here for 6 years now, so
Hey, I'm Mike Thompson. I'm from Stratford, Ontario. I just wanted to say hi to all my family and friends watching around the country.
Secret thing. Support guys, finish basketball. We appreciate everyone for watching. We hope you enjoy.
Hi, Mom and Dad and Chris. And thanks a lot for watching. And we'll hopefully get a win for you guys.
Hi, I'm Jenny. And I'm excited. I'm the basketball team.
All right, I'm going to go to our family. He thinks they have two. Let's go start.
Proceeds from sales help one alumni initiative. Go to queensu.ca/alumni for more information.
Close on that side. Almost three for Ruby over there. All right, you guys have about 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2.
queensu.ca/alumni.
Are fun, and it gives you an opportunity to have like a social life outside of your normal life. between squash team is a little more competitive. What are you doing?
Watching their upcoming game.
Hi, my name is Robin, and I'd just like to give a shout out to my family and friends in Toronto who watch me.
Hey, I'm Mike Tomlinson from Stratford, Ontario. I play for the Queensland volleyball team. And I just wanted to say hi to all my family and friends watching around the country who couldn't make it out tonight.
Hey, it's Sukrit Singh, point guard at Queens Basketball. We appreciate everyone for watching and hope you enjoy it.
Hi, Mom and Dad and Chris. And thanks a lot for watching, and we hope we're going to win through it.
Hi, I'm Jenny Knight, and I'm a guard on the Queens Basketball team. I'm just going to shout out to our fans.
queensu.ca/alumni. Did you know there's a new Queens email service for alumni starting in February? Sign up and get your own permanent Queens email address. Visit queensu.ca/alumni for more details. Alumni volunteer shuttle is a great opportunity for anyone. Need career advice? Queens University Alumni Association offers free webinars for everyone who calls to get the right career right now. Sign up at
Well, if you need a reference, I'm there.
Thank you.
I am the coach of the women's squash team, and I'm also one of the players. There's actually 14 of us. We're great.
And welcome back to the Queens Athletic and Recreation Center as we get set to start the second half. The number one team in the country, defending national champs, undefeated Carleton Ravens, leading 39-24 at halftime over the Queens Gaels. Bill Miklas along with Rachel Orosovic. And Rachel, exactly what we said near the end of the first half. You look at the shooting stats, Gaels 15 attempts from beyond the arc, only hit two of them, that's 13%. 8 for 32 from the floor, and barely over 50% from the free throw line. They're leaving too many points.
Yeah, it's definitely their offensive positive note, and tonight it's just not helping them. Carleton struggling a bit on offense, but we'll see them change it up a lot here in the second half.
Starters for both teams. Churchill backs down Shoveler and scores.
Churchill for two.
So Shoveler, the only non-starter, beginning the second half for either team. Stroud with those three personals. Lencevic fakes the three. Gets cut off by Thomas Scrub. Goes up over Scrub. Misses. Rebound Carter Springer-Williams. Ahead to Thomas Scrub from his brother Philip. Cut off. Gets it inside. Hines up. Four quick points for the Ravens. It's a much crisper offense than we saw in the first half.
Yeah, especially Hens, that's his strength. He can just step through. His footwork's unbelievable down low.
Simpson up and fouled by Churchill. And Churchill is going to take a quick seat. Or is it Springer-Williams? It's Springer-Williams.
Foul charge number 41, Kevin Churchill.
Mackenzie Simpson, he's back at the line. Fourth time there tonight. Really giving his team in the game, scoring if the clock stopped, and just being aggressive, drawing some fouls on some big players.
Simpson hits both. Carleton up by 17. Phillip Scrub. Rasso for three. Okay.
Razzle.
Characteristic offense, Carleton. Pass, pass, three.
And they're 3 for 3 from the floor here to start the second half. And we talked about this as the first half wound down, that the Ravens were going to get hot eventually. But the Gaels needed to make shots when they had the opportunities in the first half, and now the Ravens come out of the dressing room at halftime a much more aggressive team. Rasso hits back-to-back threes.
Rasso is a 40% three-point shooter. Great shooter. So is everybody else on the team.
23-point Raven lead. Shoveler. Singh. Roberts under the hoop. Got the bucket.
Roberts on the back cut. Singh with a nice pass.
Rasso doesn't take a third straight three. Hines. Phillip Scrub drives baseline. Shoveler cuts him off to brother Thomas. Takes the shot, goes in, takes contact, misses, but Hines gets the rebound. Thomas Scrub, Rasso over to Churchill. Plenty of time on the shot clock. Phillip Scrub for three. Book it.
Their ability to share the ball, quick, crisp passes, just makes all of their shot opportunities so simple, and it makes it look so easy.
Singh to Simpson, who got in behind the press.
Singh dropping by Singh down low. Those easy baskets are going to be important here.
Update from the Memorial Center, where the Gaels are leading the nationally ranked UQTR Patriot 3-2 on power play goals in the third period by Bureau and McGillis. Still plenty of time left in that one. Hines for three, misses it, follows his own miss, gets it to Churchill. Churchill against the smaller Simpson. Nice post move.
Churchill, when he catches the ball back to the basket, he's a deadly player.
Simpson almost traveled and then almost threw it away. Connor Wood, Pierre Charles check in for Carleton. Rasso and Churchill come out.
And in the game, number 10, Connor Wood. And number 13, Sean Emmanuel, Pierre Charles.
Lencevich, Street, quick fire three, got it!
The Red Rocket catches Street for three!
Quarter already, baseline three.
Rasso just came out, but he's coming back in for somebody. After that made three by Street, shot by Pierre Charles, got it.
Pierre Charles for two.
I think it's Connor Wood. Singh, do you travel? No, Thomas Scrub gets the reach. Gaels down 24, Ravens, but they haven't played that bad. They just had, in the first half, couldn't take advantage of their chances.
Yeah, it's definitely just the shooting percentage accuracy, and I really think it's the rebounds that have made the big difference.
So Pierre Charles comes out as Rasso comes back in. Roberts, pull up for two, no, nice one-handed rebound by Hines. Phillip Scrub, a lot of dribbling. Hines, Connor Wood for three, no, rebound Thomas Scrub. Caught on the baseline and was able to bounce it off Shoveler and out of bounds.
We see Phillip Scrub dribbling the ball a lot, but he's definitely one of those players who's a prober. He attacks, tries to find the open man. If it's not there, he's going to dribble back out.
Buzzer went prematurely for the sub for Stroud, so I think they're going to say Stroud can't come in. Now he can. And he'll come in for Shoveler. Wood held enough that that pass couldn't click, no call. And off Phillip Scrub drives. Thomas out to Hines. Phillip Scrub for three, no. Rebound Rasso up, misses, but he was fouled by Stroud. His fourth, and Mike Shoveler's going to be coming back pretty soon.
Gaels foul, charge number 14, Ryan Stroud. That's his fourth of the evening.
Unfortunate there for Stroud. They really need Rasso his presence inside, at least to bang around some of the bigger players on the Ravens.
Rasso hits the first. 9 points all in the last couple of minutes here in this third quarter. Now 10. Roberts. Gaels trail by 26. Street, quick fire three, got it!
He's heating up, a Red Rocket with another three.
Two in the third quarter for Patrick Street.
Hines. Roving, kicks it out, Phillip Scrub. Nice no look pass to Hines, who missed the layup. Singh. Miss Lencevich, pull up three, short. just a little out of his range. Might have had some room to take a couple of dribbles, but would have brought the roof down if he could have hit it.
Simpson will return.
And he'll take out Lencevich. The two Gale graduating players on their in their final home game. Tricolor uniform. Nice pass. Philip Strub hangs and scores.
Strub for two.
Simpson up top to Stroud, who's playing with those four fouls. Singh. Resch. Trying to stay with Singh. Roberts alone. Fires the three, in and out. Went halfway down. Connor Wood got lucky there for Carleton because he'd left for Shane Roberts. Scrub. Resch, nice catch because it was tipped by Roberts. Hines. Stroud playing with four fouls. Hines kicks it out. Phillips Scrub for three. No. Rebound on the floor. Russell comes away with it. Scrub drives. And he's fouled. If it's on Stroud, it's five. Yep. And Ryle's night is done.
Gaels foul charge number 14, Ryle Stroud.
Five fouls. 25 left in the third quarter.
Into the game with Gaels number 23, Mike Shuffler.
Frustrating night.
Stroud will shoot two for the Ravens.
Philip Scrub at the line right now. It's all these second chance opportunities here.
Misses the first free throw. 60 to 35. Ravens leading. Look like they're en route to upping their record to 20-0. And with the win, would lock up first place, as if there was ever any doubt in the East Division. Which means if the Gaels stay in sixth and go to Ryerson and upset the Rams in the quarterfinals, they'll be going
Roberts
to the Ravens.
Gets fouled on the quarterfinals. They'll go to the line shooting two.
Pretty tough path to get back to Ryerson for a second time. Because that's where the Wilson Cup, the OUA Final Four, will be held. The two surviving East teams after the division semifinals and the two West teams. Right now, Windsor and McMaster sit atop the West. Carleton and Ottawa sit atop the East. Roberts. Hits both.
Shane Roberts probably the only Queens player tonight. He just plays with zero fear. He's willing to take it at anybody.
Hines has a mismatch with Simpson. Goes up and scores.
And the footwork, I cannot say it enough. You think he's passing, and no, he's just stepping around you to lay it in for two.
Under 3 minutes left, third quarter. Ravens by 26. Simpson for three, no. Long rebound comes to Connor Wood. Wood into the front court, Thomas Scrub, dunk.
Scrub for two.
Gets it to Roberts, six on the shot clock. Roberts for three, short, long rebound, and Simpson just couldn't get it after it went through the hands of Patrick Street. 2:04 time left, third quarter.
Roberts seems to be the one deferring to take the shots because he does probably have the quickest release on the Gaels squad.
That looked like a tired shot though from Shane Roberts. Hines backing down Street. Up he goes, scores. Wow.
Hines just backed down Patrick Street from the three-point line all the way into the paint.
90 seconds left in the third quarter. Ravens foul. Attack foul on Joe Rasso. Victor Rasso, sorry.
So Victor Rasso is having a great game tonight. At least this third quarter.
Mavity, nice feed to Shoveler.
Nice find down low by Andrew Mavity.
Shoveler from the pretty feed of Mavity.
Shoveler seeing a lot more minutes tonight after Ryle Stroud fouled out.
Thomas Scrub couldn't make that catch. Mackenzie Simpson the other way, splits and draws a foul.
Good decision by Mackenzie Simpson. Doing the hop step rather than just going right in for the left-handed finish. He knew that they were looking to draw that charge.
105 time left, third quarter. And it's been Ravens right from the opening tip. Simpson misses the first. Singh might have got away with a push off. Hits the shot.
Nice push there by Singh. Tacking inside, dropping his defender, and nailing that jumper.
Thomas Scrub. Turns, falls, keeps his dribble. Hands off to Resch. Back to Thomas Scrub. Fade away. Too strong. Singh with the rebound. And a technical on Dave Smart on the Carleton bench. I think he thought Gaels were getting a little physical. Carleton. 13.3 seconds the time left in the third quarter when this happens. It's a 27-point Carleton lead, so probably isn't going to hurt the Ravens too much. Simpson will take the free throws. Rolls in the first. You don't see this very often. Both coaches near center court and allowed to be. Simpson rolls them both in. Gaels will get possession.
Simpson with 15 points on the night. Most of them from the free throw line.
Singh. We're into the last 10 seconds. Supreet Singh gets picked from Mike Shoveler. Looks for Shoveler, hit him in the knees, and then Mislencevic had it stripped by Resch. Still 3.3 seconds left. Singh will inbounds again. Mavity for two, short, and the quarter ends. So and only the two free throws off the technical to Dave Smart. His team's still up 25. They win the quarter by 10. And Dave
right,
Smart quite upset with the officials right now.
By getting on your feet and making some noise.
But nonetheless, his team leading big. And Rachel, they do it in such a methodical way.
They do it seamlessly. You know what? It's their efficiency. If you look at all of their stats, and even if you're just watching for the first time, that clean, efficient play. There's no selfish players on their team. Someone has a hot hand, they're going to find them for a shot. But it's really whoever has the open shot is going to take it. And that's why they're defending national champions.
Gavin Resch is taking the Führer of Dave Smart right now on that last sequence because he didn't switch.
But you can tell the whole team's in it as a team. It's not individualized. Not one person gets yelled at all the time.
Well, and Dave Smart says the same thing at the end of every season, especially when they win national championships and he's interviewed. He really takes his hat off to his players because he is hard on them for the entire season. And for them to keep at it and win a national championship year after year tells you something about the character of the players he recruits.
Yeah, the self-awareness. He knows the type of players he wants to go after. And his main five guys that start, even his bench, they're all in it together. They treat each other like they either play 40 minutes or 2 minutes. But right now, Gaels are going to come back out. They're trailing. But you want to finish the last quarter up strong because next weekend will be super important. You don't want to be demoralized going into an important weekend.
Dave Smart, halfway on the floor, talked to the official. And again, his complaint is that his players were getting pushed at the offensive end and then he gets a quick tee.
I'm not going to lie, though. I admire the passion.
Oh.
I truly do. Defend your players to the end.
Well, and it would be easy after all the time he's been with the program, raising it to the level he has, and how easy it seems for them to stream through a season and win a national championship, to get bored and to say, I want another challenge. But he keeps at it. Good call.
Blanchevich with the
sequence.
Blanchevich, a native of Ottawa, probably played with a lot of these guys growing up.
Williams, Thomas Scrub, and it's going to be a reach on Slencevich. And Philip Scrub may be spending the rest of the game on the bench.
Gaels foul, charge number 9, Nikola Mishinchevich. That's his third of the evening.
Charles, Rosso, Pierre Charles, didn't get the rim, but they're going to call a Gaels foul on Shoveler.
Seemed like Pierre Charles had that ball tipped when he shot it.
Well, and I think the conversation here is, did the foul happen before the shot clock expired, and it did not.
Gaels foul charge,
or sorry, it did.
Mike Shoveler.
So 14 seconds gets put on the shot clock. Carleton maintains possession. They're going to talk about it again. And all that discussion, and we're still at the inbounding by Carleton, which we were at anyway. Thomas Scrub drives around Mislencevich. Springer Williams for three, booking.
Springer Williams.
Mavity. Mislencevich thought about the three. Gets the ball back from Mavity. Five on the shot clock, double team coming. It's Simpson, somebody better shoot it. Do you step out? No, it's a foul on Rosso.
That's definitely a bailout foul. There's only 1 second left on that shot clock.
Ravens foul, charge number 15, Victor Rosso.
It does get
reset.
That's
the
second of the evening.
Back to 14 seconds.
Mislencevich.
Simpson for three. Got it.
Mackenzie
Simpson. That's his final home game. Mackenzie Simpson's putting on a show. He's got 18.
Making this one count. A nice find by his other graduating senior, Nicola.
Thomas Scrub. Panthers fourth quarter. Thomas Scrub for three. Book it.
Scrub for three.
Thomas Scrub, 12 points tonight. He's having a great weekend, dropping 25 yesterday. Say just being efficient all around.
What an upset happening at the Memorial Center right now. An empty netter for the Gaels. 15 seconds left in the game, and Queens is beating the University of Three Rivers 4-2. That comes two nights after the Gaels lost the Carr Harris Cup game 2-1 to RMC. What a huge win. The Gaels will close out their regular schedule at Three Rivers next Saturday night. And it's the playoffs. Simpson misses the three. Pierre Charles saves the ball. And Thomas Scrub comes up the floor. In for the first time for Carleton is number 31, Guillaume Payen-Boucard.
That was an impressive possession by Thomas Scrub, getting the rebound, full court, taking it by himself, finding the bucket.
Shoveler puts up the baby hook, doesn't get the roll, rebound Pierre Charles. Thomas Scrub, nice feed, but a block by Shoveler off of Payen-Boucard, and down the other end, Mavity scores.
In transition.
Andrew Mavity finishing that very intelligently, not taking the extra dribble because he knew it would have gotten pinned.
Pierre Charles. And a foul on Mavity.
Gaels foul charge number 12, Andrew Mavity.
Street and Roberts return. Mavity
for the Gaels
and
the game, number 4, Roshan Roberts. And number 11, Patrick Street.
Card swung around to Resch. Seven on the shot clock. Thomas Scrub drives. Floater in.
Scrub for two.
Nice touch inside. Another two. Thomas Scrub.
Shoveler. Street. Slencevich. Roberts for three, no. Rebound, Springer Williams. Into the front court. Takes a look. Resch is open. Doesn't take the shot. Now he'll drive around Street. Beat Pierre Charles, who goes up, blocked by Shoveler. That's the presence the rookie's going to bring for the next 4 years to the Gaels. Mislencevich for three on transition. Got it.
Nikola Mislencevich for three.
Finally knocks one down tonight. He needed that.
Gaels have not won a quarter yet, but they're on even terms here in the fourth with 5.5 left. Resch for three, no. Rebound Street. Robert. Shoveler, and he wasn't expecting the pass, and it becomes a breakout for Carleton. Payen-Boucard misses the layup.
An awkward Euro step trying to get around the defender there, and he couldn't finish.
Singh, and he stepped out of bounds.
I think there's been three calls like that this game.
And Queens is going to call a timeout.
Timeout on the board.
Check in. Resch and I think Thomas Scrub are going to come out.
Can you please welcome the Queens cheerleaders to the floor? Let's make some noise.
5 minutes left. I gotta commend Queens. They keep going. They're not giving up. They're physically imposing themselves out there. Something that a lot of teams, they kind of fall back. They're kind of like intimidated and don't, I don't know, bring aggressiveness to the defensive end. And they're really doing that all game. They've been pretty consistent.
Gaels again will close their regular season next weekend, Valentine's Day night, Valentine's night, and the 15th in Toronto against the Varsity Blues and Riders of Rams. Carleton will finish their regular season at Laurentian. and at Algoma.
Alex and Tobin have been patrolling
and the playoffs will start. The Gaels, if the playoffs started tonight, would be going to Ryerson to play the Rams as a 6th seed.
This game marks the end of their
in Ottawa, pretty close to wrapping up.
Can you please give them a
the top two spots and the byes directly to the semifinals of the division. And then the two survivors after that play on February 22nd will move on to the old Maple Leaf Gardens for the OUA Wilson Cup, joined by the two survivors from the West Division.
Yeah, and being part of the East, always a struggle to just get out because there's so many strong teams with both Ottawa teams and then Ryerson, all three ranked in the top 10.
Rasso. This is Springer Williams. Connor Wood. Baseline, might have got pushed in the back, but gets it to Pierre Charles. Springer Williams for three. No. Long rebound. He got it back. Rasso. It's a final at the Memorial Center. Gaels upset Three Rivers 4-2. Nice move, Connor Wood.
Wood for two.
Singh. Shoveler. Simpson for three. No. Long rebound, Mislencevich for three. No. Rebound, Springer Williams. Outlet to Rasso.
Gaels just really been struggling from the three-point line tonight.
Springer Williams, 10 on the shot clock. Pierre Charles on the pick and roll. Goes up, baby hook, got it. Very nice move.
Tall, long player with that hook shot. Tough to stop, even if you are Mike Shoveler's height.
By the Ravens. Wood will bring it up the floor. Wood gets around Roberts, bounce pass, Charles, foul on Shoveler.
In that last position, you can see why Smart is getting at the refs about the body contact the Gaels are imposing right now, because Roshane Roberts did bump his man, and they're all kind of just getting in there, almost causing blocks, but I guess they have to let some slide.
I'm sure Dave Smart would rather they didn't. Brody Maracle, Napanee native who played at Holy Cross for his high school career.
Charge number 23, Mike Shoveler.
We'll check in for Carleton after this free throw by Pierre Charles if it goes in.
Substitution for the Ravens in the game, number 33, Brody Maracle.
And the local contingent that came to watch him, family and friends. Give a cheer.
Saw a little smirk come on his face and heard his friends cheering.
3 minutes and counting left in the game. Nice pass by Mislencevich to Shoveler.
Mislencevich dropping nines inside. Shoveler finishes it off.
Springer Williams almost turns it over. Same pounding him. He's going to get called for being too close.
Gaels foul charge to number 7, Supreme Singh.
And I think the complaint from the Gaels would be that that was called by Dave Smart.
Third of the evening.
But that's why a head coach
works with the line shooting two. It's
the same official that gave Dave Smart the technical foul. Puts in the first. The Gaels lost at Carleton 104-65, a 39-point loss. With 2:46 left, it may not be as bad tonight. It will still end up being a loss.
Yeah, I feel like the defense is just a lot better tonight.
Well, and one wonders if the Gaels could have shot the lights out in that first half, what kind of a different game would we have had? Because Carleton did not come with their best performance.
Definitely. It would have been a different game, but ifs and buts.
Yes.
Going forever,
yes,
right?
Yes. Miss Lencevich, and they're going to say a push. And now it's Stephen Berry's turn to be told to calm down by the officials.
And also Stephen Berry's turn to make the call. So you give a little, you get a little. First year Cameron Smith just checked in for Carleton. 6'11". We got some big guys on the floor right now.
Simpson misses, crashed the boards, and they're going to say it went off Carleton and out of bounds. Ravens scored the first 7 points of the game and have never looked back. Yet, if you talk to their head coach, I think he'd say it's one of their worst performances of the season. But it's going to be to everyone else that reads the score tomorrow and on Monday, just another Carleton blowout. They lead by 31 right now. Payne Bucard, Miracle. This is Wood. And a moving pick called on Smythe. So the two players in their final home game get subbed out and get a loud round of applause. Good effort by both of them. Their season isn't done, but they won't play another home game at the Arc as a Gael. And a foul called on Rasso. 1:42 the time left.
Ravens foul, charge number 15.
Something I love about the Ravens is no matter what the score is, you're still going to see them working hard on both ends of the
court. And no matter how much time left, right to the bitter end. You're so right, Rachel. And Rashane misses the first free throw. Seems like he's been stuck on 13 points for a while. And he's off with 14. Rasso. Dylan Scrub doesn't play the entire fourth quarter. Tyson Hines doesn't play the entire fourth quarter. Devin Churchill doesn't play the entire fourth quarter. That's three of their starting five. And yet the Ravens never threatened in this one. Wood drives, hangs, feeds Miracle, scores! The local boy will go to the line for the old-fashioned three-point play.
Miracle for two. He'll go to the line.
That kind of play right there is exactly why there's different levels. Connor Wood could have finished that. He could have gone in. Maybe it might have been off in a guaranteed basket, but he dropped it off for his teammate who made it an and one.
Give the local boy the chance to send family and friends home happy. 3 points. And it's a 33-point lead for the Ravens. Gaels' record will fall to 9-11. They'll close with games against Toronto, who will miss the playoffs, and Ryerson,
Shoveler takes it to the rim,
locked into the third spot.
He gets fouled. He'll shoot two.
And then the Gaels will more than likely play Ryerson in the quarterfinal. The Ravens will improve to 20-0. Close their regular season next weekend against Laurentian and Algoma, and then host a semifinal on February 22nd against the quarterfinal winners. And then they're hoping to go to Ryerson, win the OUA championship, and then defend their national championship out east.
And there's some great contenders this year. Even though Ottawa hasn't been that close
in their contest with them
so far, Ryerson is so close this year as well. You never know what's going to happen when you're that much on the line.
I was going to say, I mean, the toughest part for the Ravens may be getting out of Ontario.
That might be it, actually. That usually happens at CIS National Championship.
Ottawa's going to be tough, and that's in their own city. Ryerson, one of those two teams, is not going to make the Wilson Cup. In all likelihood, because they'll have to play each other in the semifinals.
Yeah, I do
and
recall.
And then you've still got Windsor and McMaster on the other side.
Yeah, I recall last year Ottawa was the biggest contest for Carleton at the National Championship.
And you would expect if Carleton and Ottawa continue to win, and Carleton and Ottawa's only three losses are to the Ravens, that they would be put on separate sides of the national bracket. Three-pointer Rasso. No. Smythe couldn't hold on to the rebound. Wood tried to feed it to Smythe, picked off by Singh with 25 seconds left. Nice move with Shane Roberts.
Roberts takes it to the hole.
Shane Roberts pretending there wasn't a 6'11 defender there, just going in for the two.
Dave Smart, who never looks happy after any Carleton win, certainly won't look happy tonight. Carleton will let the clock run out. The Traveling Roadshow wins by 32.
Thank you for attending today's match.
They're 20-0, but the Gaels, one would think, if they could have shot better, it might have been different, Rachel.
No, they have to be okay with this result. Both teams came out. They played hard to the end. If you didn't look at the score, you wouldn't know there was that big of a discrepancy. But, you know, move on to the next weekend, and those are necessary wins for the Gaels going into the playoffs.
Two games left in the regular season for both teams, and the postseason starts the week of February 19th. Gaels lose this one 91-59. For Rachel Rosevic and the entire crew, thanks for watching Gaels basketball tonight, courtesy of TV Kojiko and Queens TV.
To give a shout out to my family and friends in Toronto who are watching me play.
Hey, I'm Mike Tomlinson from Stratford, Ontario. I play for the Queens Men's Volleyball team, and I just wanted to say hi to all my family and friends watching around the country who couldn't make it out tonight.
Hey, it's Sukhpreet Singh, point guard at Queens Basketball. We appreciate everyone for watching. We hope you enjoy.
Hi, Mom and Dad and Chris, and thanks a lot for watching, and we'll hopefully get a win for you guys.
Hi, I'm Jenny Wright, and I'm a guard on the Queens Men's Basketball team, and I'm just giving a shout out to our fans across the country.
Show your Queen's spirit. Purchase an official Queen's University diploma frame and proudly display your degree. Proceeds from the sales help fund alumni initiatives. Visit queensu.ca/alumni for more information. Rob Baker and Carol Allison Burrow are being honored by the Kingston branch of the Queen's University Alumni Association. Join them at the Padre Laverty Jim Bennett Achievement Award Dinner on May 7th. For details, visit queensu.ca/alumni. Did you know there's a new Queen's email service for alumni starting in February? Sign up and get your own permanent Queens email address. Visit queensu.ca/alumni for more details. The Alumni Volunteer Summit is a great opportunity for anyone who wants to volunteer with Queens to learn and network with other Queens supporters. The summit takes place over the April 5th weekend. For more details, go to queensu.ca/alumni. Do you need career advice? Queens University Alumni Association is offering a free webinar on February 12th called Get the Right Career Right Now. To sign up, visit queensu.ca/alumni.
Week 5 has arrived and we're barely making it through. 5 more days of midterms and then we're free for reading week. I'm Danielle Bangle for QTV and here's what you might have missed during a crazy week 5. Have you ever been to a bar that isn't ale, stages, or the brass? This week in Kingston Life, we had a beer at some pubs that aren't in the hub. In student life, our team hit the streets to find out what Queen's students' proudest moments are. In comedy this week, hard-hitting music journalist discovered a new and upcoming act, Hugo and the Astrodirt Weavers.
In arts and entertainment, we interviewed Canadian hip-hop artist Shad after his show at the Grad Club.
A new hilarious episode of Put Me In Coach came out this week and asked the question, what do we know about squash? And remember to catch up with your Queens Gaels varsity teams by watching our weekly sports highlight reel. Our live sports team has their busiest weekend yet with 9 games over 3 days. Support your volleyball and basketball teams by watching in person, online, or live at QP. Cheesy garlic breadsticks, anyone? Links to all the segments you've seen here are easily accessible in the description box below. Make sure to check out our Tumblr blog and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Queens TV for all your news and entertainment updates. I'm Danielle Bangle for QTV, and if enough people like this post on Facebook, next week's segment will be done outside without a coat on. Stay golden, Queens!
This is how we do it.
My name is Heather Lamb, and I am the coach of the women's squash team, and I'm also one of the players.
There's actually 14 of us, and we're a great group of ladies, and we have a lot of fun together and enjoy playing together.
Well, they're great. Like, being in first year, they're such great role models for me. They always help me out. They're there to support me. And especially being a rookie, they always, like, are willing to hit with me, give me encouragement, and it's just, like, a great environment.
It's a great opportunity to exercise, meet new friends, the socials are fun, and it gives you an opportunity to have like a social life outside of your normal one at Queens.
The Queens squash team is a little more competitive.
Fun?
Definitely harder than expected.
Make sure you check out Queen Squash and their upcoming games.